So the three data feeds have already seen the background, the standards, how good data should be. They have seen some assessments on how to detect what can possibly be wrong, or initial ways of how to improve what's going to be what's wrong. And today we will be focusing on data cleaning tools, methods, applications, and work. So if the past 2 days have been a 50-50 theory and practice, we will try this day today to be more practice oriented than theory. So we will try to keep our positions as short as possible so that we can give you more time to do exercises. So all the data you have seen already, all the maps and all the problems that it's real data, it's actual data that's available there. And that data can, and in fact is, used for serious research. I imagine the implications of not bothering about checking the quality of the information before we use it. So dirty data, data with issues, with quality issues, with usability issues, hamper the uses of the information and also hamper the reliability of the conclusions. We make an analysis based on bad data, the results will not be reliable. That would not be the truth. So when data publishers and institutions agree to share published their collections, they are signing a memorandum of understanding. They are signing an agreement that they will keep their data up to date and as free of errors as possible. It's not possible, but it's very, very, very difficult to have a completely error-free collection. But there's a lot of work that can be done to improve this. So even though most of these errors come from the original data, by collecting different sources together, using data from different institutions, that union of collections might also raise some issues in the data, some problems of interoperability. So in today's session, we're going to work with data cleaning, which is the process of detecting and correcting or removing corrupt or inaccurate records from a record set, table, or database. The main purpose of data cleaning is to improve the content, make it better and more useful. So there are two different concepts here that are related but are not the same. The first one is data quality. Data quality is the correct representation of the real world. Data is of high quality. If data are of high quality, they correctly represent the real world construct to which they refer. So it's an abstract concept that deals with the correctness of data. Data is okay if it represents the world and is high quality. The other concept is the fitness for use, which refers to a scale of data quality as part of the data quality. But it's more focused on the accuracy, precision, and especially the intended use. The fitness for use is the kind of quality that deals with a specific use. So data quality is a broader term than fitness for use. But they are related, since if we have high quality data, abstractly high quality data, that data would be more useful, would be fit for more purposes, for more uses. So the general workflow of data quality assessment and data cleaning would be something like this. We get the data, we have produced the data, and we explore it. We explore all our records, explore our spreadsheets, our tables, our databases, to detect or dig up the possible issues. This is what the assessment section does, right? So when we assess a collection, we're looking for possible issues. Then we find the appropriate tools, and many of them we're going to show you in this session. And we apply these tools or methods. This is the critical step of error flagging or data cleaning. And once must validate the output. We must re-examine this data so that we know that it's accurate, it's correct. If we have really improved the data, not make it worse. Last of what we will see tomorrow is the publishing part. Once we have